that's going to change everything. All right. We're on the right course now, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like to take a moment and address you, if I may, and tell you about the musicians that are up here entertaining or attempting to entertain you right now. I'm going to start with the horns. The Supernatural Snatch Brothers. Snatch and Snatch Bow Snatch. It's interesting to me that they would pick that moment to do that. I'm going to ask them about that later. All right, let's turn our attention to some of the many guitar players. Let's start with my left-hand man, your right-hand man, if you're facing the stage. Or, I don't know, if you're over there, I don't know what side he's on. If you're over there, he's the guy over here. Now, a lot of people, they ask me, Mr. E, what does it take to put on a rock and or roll show? And I simply tell them, you just gotta bring it. It's that simple. But maybe it's not that simple. Because it turns out you have to be born with the bring it gene. And this guy that I'm about to introduce to you right now, he brings it every night. Even when he forgets to bring it. The Chet! Stage, recently voted Guitar Player Magazine's Trumpet Player of the Year, P-Boo! Entrance, as some call it, from the four-string electric bass guitar. Some of the older members of the audience might even remember his older brothers, Big and Crazy, introducing for the first time in Boston, Massachusetts, the tiniest member of the Al Brood, Tiny Al! Is most definitely out of school. All right, and that leaves the man seated behind me, the only man who gets to sit down among us all night. Must be nice, huh? Yeah. Basically, the only person seated in this room right now. Must be nice. I'm going to tell you a few things about this man, and exactly just a few things. There's only three things in the world that this man holds dearly to his heart.
He's a Swedish chef.
Stop talking to me, asshole. I got a microphone and putting on a rock and roll show if you haven't noticed, dildo. Alright. Now where was I? I'm going to list the three things that the man seated behind me holds dearly to his heart in reverse order of importance to himself. The third most important thing in the world to the man seated behind me And ladies and gentlemen, this is an amazing coincidence, and he couldn't be more excited that we happen to be here tonight, because it just so happens to be eating Boston baked beans. Sounds like you like them more than they do. Well, he's been doing it all day. You know what that means. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the second most important thing in the world is the man seated behind me. And again, an amazing coincidence that we happen to be here tonight. This must be the greatest day of his life. Because it just so happens to be eating Boston cream pie. Yes, he can't get enough. He just stuffs his face into that shit. Any chance he can. Not good beard food. But he doesn't care. He doesn't give a shit. All right, ladies and gentlemen, now I'm going to tell you about the first and most important thing in the life of the man seated behind me. And luckily for you people here tonight, it just happens to be playing the drums while simultaneously singing a song about himself, which he's about to do for you right now. And his name is Knuckles, baby!